model, that is Q data structure. What is Q? Q is also a linear data structure. It is a linear data structure in which the elements can be added from one end, called as a rear end, whereas the elements can be removed from other end, that is called as front end. Consider an example of best bus, where there are two doors, right? And consider people who enter into the bus follow the discipline. They enter into the bus from rear end, whereas they exit from the bus from the front door. It means that you can enter into the bus from rear door, whereas you can exit from the bus from front door. Insertion takes place at rear end, whereas deletion takes place at front end. I'll show you the diagram of Q. This is a general example where a queue of people standing in front of a ticket counter, suppose. What is happening there? The person who is standing first in the queue gets the ticket first at the ticket counter, railway ticket counter. When he gets the ticket, he exits from the queue. Then the next immediate person gets the control of getting the ticket. It means that it follows the principle of first come, first serve. It is also called as, queue is also called as first in, first out data structure. It follows the principle of first in, first out. Okay. Now you see here, the people are entering into this queue from the rear door, rear end. So the end from which you can enter into the queue is called as rear end, whereas the end from which you exit from the queue is called as front end. I have given you an example of best bus. There are two doors, right? The back door is called rear end, whereas the front door is called as front end. People enters into the bus from the rear end, whereas they exit from the bus from the front end. Means one door is responsible for only one activity, right? So rear door, rear end is only utilized for entering the value inside the queue, whereas the front end is only utilized for deleting a value from the queue. Then where we find the different applications of queue in real life? Can anybody tell me? You can write your answer into the chat room. Where you have seen the application of queue? Just write the answer into the chat so that I'll come to know whether you understood the principle of queue or not. Where we can use queue in real life? Sachet is writing railway station for getting the ticket. Okay, next. Anywhere you have seen the application of queue? Students, write your answer in the chat. Where we can implement queue, or where you have seen queue in real life? Nowadays, if you go to the bank, suppose, what happens? When you go to the bank, there is a machine which generates the ticket for you. That is a waiting queue, right? So it generates a number, and whenever the numbers comes at the counter, you have to go to the counter and you have to do that work, right? So that everywhere, like if you go to theater also for watching the movie, there also to generate the ticket, the software uses queue. It always generates the next number on the ticket. Suppose a ticket 10 is disbursed, then the next ticket will be ticket number 11, and so on. Pina writing mall counter. Yes, whenever you enter into the mall, suppose there is a queue of people entering into the queue mall, then the queue comes into the picture. We are first come, first serve, right? First in, first out. Now consider an example of your practical lab in college, where there are several computers, there are many computers, and there is only one printer. There are many computers and one printer. Now what happens if multiple students, more than one students, send the print command to the printer? Then what happens? Whether all the pages comes out at once, it never happen. It is like there is a model, a software model called as print school available inside the driver of a printer. print spooler takes all the commands given by the users for printing. It takes all the commands given by the user for printing, and then it executes those commands of printing one after the another. The person who given the print command first will be given a chance for printing the page first. Okay, and it actually forms a queue of commands given by different users, and it executes that commands one after the another in first come first serve manner. Is it okay, students? Have you understood what is queue is? Please write your answer in the chat whether you understood the principle of queue or not. Okay, who is writing something? Pranav Dave. What everywhere is a queue. Okay, queue makes the most sense, almost all the queue, because once you are the first in, then out to be the first. If we two are first in, consider them as one and all discrepancies are resolved. Okay. So I think you understood what is queue is, right? Now we'll see what are different operations that we can perform on queue. The way we studied different operations on stack, now we'll study what are different operations that we can perform on queue. See, here there are certain examples I have given here of applications of queue. Queue of people at a service point, such as ticketing. Queue of processes in operating system. Now, when you are working on a desktop or laptop, you can press Control Alt Delete, and you can get a taskbar, task manager, where you can see there are n number of processes are running simultaneously inside the CPU, correct? In OS, there are n number of processes are running simultaneously. Then how only one CPU handle these processes which are running simultaneously? The CPU handles all these processors, thousands of processors, in first come first serve manner. So the process which enter in the execution first will get the chance for execution first, and the next immediate will get the next chance, and so on, right? So there is only one CPU which handles multiple tasks at the same time. That's why you can able to do multitasking in operating system. Another application is queue of packets in data communication. Now, when you send data from one machine to another machine, it always sent in the form of packets. What is packet? It may be one word, two word data at a time. It's sent from one machine to another machine. That total depends upon the speed of your microprocessor, right? So it always send the data in the form of packets from one machine to another machine. But when it forms the packets, it always kept in the manner first come first serve fashion, and then it will be disbursed from the system. Queue of airplanes waiting for landing instructions. There you can find the applications of queue. So what are different applications that different operations that we can perform on queue? There are three basic operations. First of all, one is in queue, another is queue, and third is display. Others are supported operations. You can say finding the pick element, then pip for display, right? But basically there are only three fundamental operations that we can do on queue. One is enqueue, another is queue, and the third is display. Enqueue operation in queue. What do you mean by enqueue? Enqueue is nothing but inserting an element in the queue from the rear end. It's called as enqueue operation. Always the insertion takes place from the rear end of the queue, and that of inserting any element into the queue is called as enqueue operation. Then what is dequeue operation? Dequeue operation is nothing but deleting an element from the queue, from front end, is called as dequeue operation. We always delete the front element the element which is available at the front door will be deleted first from the, okay. So insertion happens from the rear end, whereas deletion happens from the front end. Now what happens in NQ operation when you insert an element into the queue? Whenever you insert any element into the queue, the rear pointer is always incremented by one. That's always point last element of the queue, right? The same way we studied in stack, the top pointer gets incremented. When you insert any element into the stack, the top is incremented, right, by one. Similarly, when the elements enter into the queue, the rear pointer is also incremented by one. Now, the another operation is dequeue, where we actually delete the element from the queue, and always it picks the first element of the queue and it deletes that. So if the first element is deleted, the pointer should point to the immediate next element of the queue. So when the first element is deleted, it should always point, the pointer always point to the next element, immediate next element of the queue. So it means whenever you delete operation, in dequeue operation, front pointer is incremented by one, which actually points to the immediate next element after deletion. Then the third operation is displaying operation, which displays all the elements of the queue. Then there is another operation called as pick, which actually displays the front element of the queue. That displays the front element of the queue. With NQ operation, with help of NQ function, we can insert elements into the queue. Unlike stack, queue have two ends open, that is front and rear. Elements are inserted from the rear end. Note is very important here. Whenever you perform NQ operation on queue, you implement queue using array, again there is a size limitation, because you are utilizing array for implementing. Okay, so you use array for implementing queue. Then whenever you use array for implementing, then there is always an overflow exception or error occurs. What is that? Suppose my queue size is 5 and I am trying to insert 6th element. I inserted 5 elements, suppose, and I want to insert 6th element into the queue. Then definitely that program should generate an error that the queue is full. There is no space remained empty for inserting that newly coming element, 6th element. So if the size of the queue is 5, you can insert only 5 elements, or the queue accommodate only 5 elements. No 6th element is allowed to enter into the queue. Okay. So that situation is called as queue overflow. Then in dequeue operation, we always check underflow condition. You understood what is overflow condition and underflow condition in stack. The same thing also there in queue, because we are going to use array to implement queue in this chapter. Now in dequeue operation, with the help of dequeue function, we can remove element from the stack, element from the queue. There are two ends in the queue, that is front and rear. We always delete element from the front door of the queue. Before deletion of an element, always check one condition, that is queue underflow condition. Why this is needed in the program? Because if you try to perform dequeue operation on empty queue, then definitely there will be an exception or there is an error. There are no elements for deletion. You are trying to perform delete operation on empty queue, then there is a problem, and that problem is called as queue underflow condition, which occurs when there is no element in this queue. This is by mistake written stack, but it is queue. If there are no elements into the queue, which can be removed from the queue when the queue is empty. In this operation, always displays all the elements of the queue from front end to the rear end. It always goes from front end to the rear end. It means all the elements of the queue are displayed in the same order in which they entered into the queue. All the elements of the queue are displayed in the same order in which they entered into the queue. That is called as display operation. Then the last operation is queue operation, The pick function displays the element present at the front end, front door. It means whatever may be the element present at the first place into the queue will be displayed by which function? It is displayed by pick function. Okay. Now we'll try to implement queue using array. So we'll see all these things and we'll try to code all these functions, NQ, DQ, display and pick. And we'll try to implement queue using array. Any questions till this point? Any questions, students? You can ask. We have covered theory part. Now we are moving for implementation of queue using array. So we'll see practically how to implement queue using array. Any questions till this point? Okay, no question. So we'll see the program on our compiler, that is online compiler, that is onlinegdb.com. Here the code is there. We'll try to. Is it visible to all of you, the code? Now all of you please check, is the code visible to you? So this is the program to implement queue using array. These are standard lines that we write in every program. stdio.h, then standard library.h header file that we have taken, because we are going to use exit function in the program to exit from the program. To stop the program, we are going to use exit function. Then I have used the size of the array by max function. I use max function, max variable here to limit the size of the array or to limit the size of the queue. So as defined, max is 5 here. We just focus on the structure, how it is written in this program. The structure consists of two parts. One is called as variables that we declare is rear and front, because there are two doors, two variables are needed to focus inside the queue. One is front and another is rear. Front is responsible for deletion and rear is responsible for insertion of an element inside the queue. Then I needed array locations, queue locations where I can actually insert the elements inside the queue. So I declared one array of A of 10. Then this is the queue way by which we can access all these members of the queue. Is it okay, student, how we declared this structure? This is very important. Stack has only one pointer, that is top. So we declare integer top equals to minus 1 there. Then we have taken also an array for implementation of stack. So here we need array. And then we need two variables, front and rear. Whenever you perform insertion, array is incremented by 1. When you perform deletion, front will be incremented by 1 in this linear queue. Okay. Then we come to the main program. There we actually declare all the variables that we are going to use in this program. Okay. See here, I am going to use variable n, I, and k. What is n? N is the number that you are inserting into the queue, whereas I is for traversing inside the queue, moving from one end to another end of the queue. I have used a for loop. In for loop, I need one index, that index is I. What is K? K is the choice, because we are going to show a menu card to the user. This is a menu driven program, because we want to show a menu card to the user where we actually show the different operations that we are going to perform on the queue. The operations are NQ, DQ, display, and exit. Okay, so you see in the next line, I have given here, this line is responsible for displaying a menu card to the user. So the menu card consists of four options, NQ, one for NQ, two for DQ, three for display, and four for exit. on the immediate next line, I want to tell the compiler that initially my queue is empty, linear queue is empty. But how to show that? The way we did it in stack implementation, to tell the compiler that the stack is empty initially, we assigned s dot top equals to minus one. Similarly, here also, we'll assign the rear pointers to minus one. So that's why I written here q dot front equals to zero, because it is the front door, it always point to the first element, whereas q dot rear equals to minus one. Okay, so this is the condition for empty queue in linear queue. Q dot front equal to zero and q dot rear equals to minus one is the condition for empty queue in linear queue. Then you know this, in while one, inside this switch case, we have written the code. We are seeing the same template in implementation of stack using array. Again, I use the same thing here. What is while one? While one is the infinite loop. It means we want to perform this operation NQ, DQ, display, and exit according to the choice of the user. The user may wants to execute NQ, DQ, display operation n number of times, and later on he wants to exit from the program. So to execute same operation again and again, I need an infinite loop. So I used while one. While one is true, always true. It is an infinite loop. As soon as you enter an infinite loop, you have to take a choice for the user. Ask the user what you should do on the queue. So that option will be stored into variable k. That option will be stored into variable k here. Check this. First rules. So after scanf percentage j ampersand k means we got the choice from the user what you want to perform on the queue. As soon as you got the choice, you apply switch case. There you have to write the code for insertion, deletion, display, and exit. You can convert this program into a function program also later on. We'll see that function program. Now I have given a basic template program where we are performing NQ, DQ, and display operation on queue. As soon as you get your choice into k variable, the switch case will jump to case one if the choice entered by the user is one. So here in case one, our job is to insert the new element inside the queue. But before inserting any new element in the queue, we have to check queue overflow condition. We have to check queue overflow condition. And how are we going to check that queue overflow condition? This is the condition. If q dot rear equals to max minus one, this is very, very important. This is the condition which is required to check q overflow condition. What is max? Max is the size of the array, size of the queue, correct? So we are checking, is the q dot rear index matched to the last index of the queue or not, or last index of the array? If that is true, then you can simply say that, print a message that the queue is full. The queue is full. Otherwise, I want to insert the element inside the queue. It means the queue has certain blocks empty where you can insert the elements. So as soon as you go to the else part, you will ask now the user which element you want to insert. Please enter the element that you want to insert. So by this print, I will prompt a message to the user where I'll take a number from the user. That number will be stored into variable n. With the help of scanf, we read the number and we store that variable, that value into variable n. Once you got the number, your job is to put that number inside the queue. But before putting that value inside the queue, you have to increment rear pointer by one. So if you see this line, this is the important line where I combine two lines into one line of code. If you see carefully this expression q dot a of plus plus q dot rear equals to n. In this actual expression, q dot plus plus q dot rear will be executed first because it has the higher precedence than assignment operator. So q pointer will be incremented by one first, and then at the particular location of q, rear n will be assigned inside the queue. Then after completing this, we'll exit from the case one with the help of break. How we did this, we take the number from the user, then we incremented rear pointer by one, and at that particular location of the rear pointer of queue, we assigned value n. Now, how many times we can do this? We can do this till the size of the queue. That is max. Okay. So NQ operation is allowed till Q reaches to max minus 1. And if it is more than that, then it won't allow you to insert any further elements inside the queue. Any questions till NQ operation, students? Any questions in NQ? Please check. Check the code and let me know. Any question that you have in this case 1, where we actually performing the NQ operation. Check the shaded area. I highlighted the area of case 1 where we actually performing NQ operation. Any question if you want to ask me, please ask. You can write your question in the chat. Tushar, no question. Okay. Other students, please reply. Do you have any question in NQ operation? Okay. Okay. It means you understood what is NQ operation is. The next one is DQ operation. So we are going to write the code in case 2. The case 2 is responsible for DQ operation. Okay. So whenever the user enters option number 2 in a variable, then it will be supplied to switch case. Then switch case will jump to case 2 if k value is 2. In case 2, we are actually performing the DQ operation here. Before performing DQ operation on this queue, you have to check one condition. That is very, very important, because if the queue is empty and if you try to perform DQ operation, then there is an exception, there is an error. That error has to be handled by your program. And that error is called as queue underflow condition. Queue underflow. Okay. Then how do you check whether the queue is empty or not? Condition we have written at the beginning itself. Q dot front equal to 0 and Q dot rear equals to minus 1. Or in other words, you can say that whenever Q dot front is greater than Q dot rear, then you can say that the queue is empty. Whenever in linear queue it happens that Q dot front is greater than Q dot rear, front greater than rear, whenever it happens, then the queue, linear queue is empty. Linear queue is empty. Else, if the queue is not empty, then you can delete the element from the queue. If the queue is not empty, it comes to the else part, and this is the code which actually delete the value from the queue. To understand this code, just imagine that you have a queue of 5 elements where the elements are 10, first element is 10, second is 20, 30, 40, and last element is 50. Now, if you perform this DQ operation, which element should be deleted? The first element, that is 10, from the queue. The first element has to be deleted. Now, this for loop, I have written a code in such a way that the actual 10 is deleted from the memory. And this is achieved by left shifting operation. It means we are overwriting immediate next element on the current element, immediate next element on the current element, right? So it means that when you perform this for loop, 20 gets overwritten on 10, 30 gets overwritten on 20, 40 gets overwritten on 30, and 50 gets overwritten on 40. But the last 50 remains as it is in the last block. If you see this example of elements inside the queue, just imagine there are 5 elements, 10, 20, 30, 40, 50. Now if you do left shifting of next element on the previous element, next element on previous element, what will happen? 20 gets overwritten on 10, means 10 is not there now. 20 comes in the first place, whereas 30 will come to the place of 20, 40 will come to the place of 30, 50 will come to the place of 40, and last 50 remains as it is in the fifth, fourth block of the last block of the queue. It's number 4, you have element number 50. Now you are deleted successfully 10 from the queue, then immediately will decrement rear by 1. Immediately will decrement rear pointer by 1. But to show to the user that actual 10 is deleted from the computer's memory, we will show one message to the user that element deleted is percentage D and it is always present at the Q dot A of Q dot front location, because the element which you delete from the queue is present at the first location. So this line, the printf line will display, this first line will display that element that you are going to delete. Or you can say that the element has been deleted. But in computer, that change has to happen. So we have written this code, which will delete that element 10 from the queue. You are deleting first element from the queue with the help of left shifting operation, where we actually perform the overriding task of next element over previous element. Now there is another method of writing DQ operation. Just implement what you will. You can write that line here in the single line itself. I am writing it in comment. You can understand what is that line is. So I will show to the user. Here I am writing. What is the effect of this line? Please check the shaded line, which is given the comment. This is also going to delete an element from the queue. But whether this will actually delete the element from the queue, it is just a code where it shows that the element deleted is present at the front, and at last it increment the front pointer 1. This is called as postfix post increment operator, right? It is called as post increment operator. Means you do the task, you do everything, and at last you increment the pointer by 1. You increment the variable value by 1. So you are saying to the user that you deleted front element, and later on you incremented front pointer by 1. Whenever you perform delete operation, front has to be incremented by 1 to show to the compiler that the next element becomes the front element of the queue. So that is also possible by this single line. But the drawback of this particular method of implementation of DQ operation in queue using array is that on front side, your some of the memory blocks gets wasted. Assume that you have deleted 2 elements from your original queue, that is 10, 20, 30, 40, 50. You deleted 10 and 20. Where is your front pointer? It is at 30, right? It is pointing to 30. And where is your rear pointer? It is pointing to 50. You can easily see by your eyes that 2 blocks are empty. Still, you cannot insert any element inside this queue because your rear pointer is used to the last index of the array, last index of the queue. And to avoid this drawback of linear queue, we have another queue called as circular queue that we'll study in tomorrow's lecture. But today, just to understand what is DQ operation in linear queue and what is the drawback of DQ operation here, and whenever you implement queue using array, always there is a memory wastage. I have given you an example where you have 5 elements inside the queue, say 10, 20, 30, 40, 50. Out of that, you deleted, say, 2 elements. You deleted 2 elements. Then what happens? Your front pointer points to the element number 30, whereas your rear pointer points to the last index of the array, that is 50, right? Though you have 2 blocks empty from front side, you are not able to insert any elements into the queue because your rear pointer is raised to last index of the linear queue. So this is the major drawback of linear queue, which will be overcome by circular queue. We'll see that later. So this method is also valid. If you write this code in your final exam, that is also valid. That is the principle of your linear queue. So now I am deleting this line. Second, the previous method was this, so I delete this. and this method is better because this method actually deletes the front element from the queue. Okay, but the advantage of second method of implementation of DQ operation is that you are actually perform left shifting. It means that the last block become vacant, where we actually delete or where you can actually insert the next element inside the queue. Okay, that is the advantage. So no memory wastage happens because of this second method of DQ operation. Okay. Any questions, students, in case 2 in DQ operation? Please ask your question. Just check the code of DQ operation that I have written here. And if you understood, please let me know. Or if you have any doubts, you can write your doubts inside the chat. Any questions, students? Tushar is writing. Okay. If we use left shifting, there is no memory loss, right? No, there is a memory loss also, because if you see what we did in left shifting, we overwriting everything, right? But what about the last block where your point was there? Actually, the last block remains as it is. The value is there, that is occupied. Okay, we just decremented rear pointer by one. We just decremented rear pointer by one. That is for our convenience, because we wanted to insert more elements. Your rear pointer is decremented by one, and then it is also possible to insert the element. It is more far better than your previous method, conventional method of implementing DQ operation. So we just modified the code, little bit code of DQ operation. That is also valid code, because it follows the principle of first come, first serve. Only the thing is that in this method, you can insert elements. If some blocks are empty, you can insert element. Avi is saying, sir, I didn't understand what is Q over here. Is it a pointer to rear and front? See, whenever we use structure and if we use normal variable, this is a Q variable, which actually using the members of the Q. Yes, Suresh Parker is writing, Q is structure variable. Yes, it is a structure variable that is responsible for accessing the elements of the structure. You might have studied this in C programming language, how to access this structure variable. That's it. It is not a pointer, it is a structure variable which is responsible for accessing the elements of the structure. We are going to use pointer concept in dynamic implementation. This is static implementation, Avi. This is static implementation. We are going to use that in linked list. We will use this concept of pointer in linked list, because there we need to allocate memory dynamically. We need to access the elements dynamically, randomly. Okay, that we'll study later. Shivani Agarwal, what is Q dot A? Q dot A is the Q, actual Q. A is the array. It is the locations of the Q, right? Q of A, Q dot A is nothing but your actual array locations of the Q, right? Any other questions? Okay. No questions, students. If there are no questions, we can move to the next operation, that is display. And they will study how to display elements of the queue. And remember that we have to follow the principle of first come, first serve. It means the element inserted first has to be removed first from the queue. So we will take the third case number 3. A small code I have written here, which will display all the elements of the queue. Just focus on the shaded area. Before displaying any element from the queue, again, you need to check, are there any elements for display or not? It means you are checking whether the queue is empty or not, right? How to check that queue is empty or not? The simple condition is, if queue dot front is greater than queue dot rear, whenever this condition comes in linear queue, we say that your linear queue is empty. So if this condition is true, then we can say queue is empty. Otherwise, we'll go to the else part. I will display all the elements from front end to the rear end. We'll move one by one from front end to the rear end. We'll pick the Q element at the front and we'll display. And then front pointer will be shifted to the next place. Like this, this process goes on till you reach to the last location of the queue. It means it will display all the elements from front to rear. Okay. To do that, if you just focus on the else part, the code for for loop, this is very important now. See, the queue contents will be the message for the user, and for loop will going to actually display all the elements of the how for loop is written. I is initialized to queue dot front because it is starting with index number 0. Where is your queue dot front? It is at index number 0. You can write here this queue dot front also, no problem. Queue dot front. And where is your queue dot front pointer right now? It is at 0. It is a variable which is pointing to index number 0. Semicolon, I less than equal to q dot rear. So rear is the variable which stores the index, last index of the queue. So we are going from first index of the queue till the last index of the queue, and every time we are incrementing I value by 1. It means we are going from one element to another element, one after the another, linearly. And inside the for loop, we actually print the value of the queue. Statement printf percentage d q of I, q dot a of I. So you pick that q element and display. How many times you can do this till you reaches the q dot rear? It allows you to display all the elements of the queue. And as soon as you reach to the last location, and after you displayed the last value from the queue, the condition becomes false and it stops displaying the elements of the queue. Another fourth case is for exit from the program. To stop the program completely, we are going to use exit 0 function. And to use this exit 0 function, on top you have to include one header file that is called as, here you have to include header file called as standard library.h, stdlib.h, which actually consists of the function exit function. So whenever you need such function, you need to import that header file in your main program at the top. Okay, so this is the end of case. If any other case is entered by the user, if any other choice entered by the user apart from the several cases available, suppose option number 5, 6 or 7 is entered, then in that case, it directly comes, the compiler directly comes to the default path to handle the errors, where will print a message on the screen that the choice that you have entered is wrong, please enter a valid choice. This is the message to the user. Here we actually handle the error of the program. If the user enter any option which is not available into the menu card, then it is a wrong choice. So this is the end of the switch, this is the end of the while loop, and at last we'll stop the program by return 0. I'll execute this program, then we'll understand how Q works. Just click on this run button to execute the program. Now, this is my code. Successfully executed, there are no errors. Now the compiler is asking me, this is the menu card displayed by the compiler. Now the program is asking me, enter the choice. I'll enter 1. 1 means I want to perform NQ operation. Then I want to pass the number to the compiler, because the compiler is asking me now, enter an element to be inserted. I inserted 10. The size of the queue was 5, mentioned in the program. So I will insert all the elements here. Again, the option number 1 with the value 20. Then again, option number 1 with the value 30. Next value inserted will be 30. Okay. After inserting 30, I want to insert the next. I'll share this code with you. You can try this code at your home. It will work fine. If you have doubt, we can discuss your doubts in tomorrow's lecture, because it's now 11:56. Now I want to know any doubts that you have in the implementation of queue using array. All of you, I want to answer from all the students. Have you understood how to implement queue using array? Write your answer in the chat. whether you understood or not how to implement queue using array. Okay, many of you are writing yes means you understood, right? It's not like that. The only one question is there. There will be 2-3 questions to check whether you really understood how to implement queue using or not array or not. Okay. So let me check whether you understood or not. My first question coming is to you is, what is the empty condition of queue? How do, when you implement queue using array, how do you check whether the queue is empty or not? Write your answer in the chat. Do not leave the meeting, it is not over. I need to record your attendance. Students, ask the student who left right now to rejoin the meeting because their attendance has to be recorded. All of you, the question to you is, how do you check whether the queue is empty or not? Okay, okay, Mohammed Sheikh, Snehal, Ashwin, Kumar, Sachin, Badal Oja, good. Many of you have written the correct answer. Okay, why do we need to check this condition when you implement stack using or queue using array? Why do we need queue underflow condition to be checked? What will happen if this condition is not written and you perform the queue operation on queue? Okay. Tushar is saying that it is queue underflow to check whether the queue is underflow or not. Mohammed is saying if queue is empty, you cannot delete any elements from the queue. True. Shreya, to check queue underflow and not to delete from empty queue. Very good, very good. Any other ones to add to this question? Any wants to add anything to the answer? Rutuja is saying to check if there is element present for deletion. Very good. So ultimately, meaning is same, all of you. All answers are correct. The last question now. How do you check queue overflow condition? How do you check queue overflow condition in queue when you implement queue using array? How do you check queue overflow condition? Okay, many of you have written the same answer, and that is it. Very good. So it means you understood what is queue overflow, what is queue underflow, right? Queue is also called as dash data structure. Write your answer. Queue is also called as dash data structure. Okay, I got the first answer, second answer, third answer. Very good. It's a linear data structure. But what is the principle of queue? Nainesh Rathod is right. It's FIFO. It's FIFO. It's a FIFO data structure. First in, first out. Okay, what is stack? Stack is also called as dash data structure. You have to fill it blank. Very good, very good. Snail, many of Rutuja also, very good. Nainesh, Rutuja, Janvi, All of you are correct. It is called as LIFO. It is called as LIFO. And it is also called as PHYLO. Am I right or wrong? It is also called as PHYLO data structure. PHYLO means what? First in, last out. Very right. Very good. And what is LIFO? It is last in, first out. Both the meanings are same. So please check this. LIFO and PHYLO. LIFO means last in, first out. PHYLO means first in, last out. One and the same thing. In your examination, they may confuse you by this. Okay. So make sure that you are picking the correct answer. Stack is also called as LIFO and PHYLO data structure. Or it is also called as PHYLO data structure. First in, last out data. Okay. Now I request all the students to switch on the camera. Take your attendance. I want everyone to switch on the camera.